wasn't that experience of the boys who were in Thailand, trapped in the cave, wasn't that powerful? For those of you who don't know, there was a soccer team of boys and a coach, and they went exploring these caves. They were about a mile in, and then all this rain came, and they got trapped. It took about 2 weeks for divers, scuba divers, to even find them. And once they found them, they didn't know how they're going to rescue them. Again, more rain is going to come. They tried pumping out the water, all these things. Finally, what they did, and this just happened this week, is that they had each one of the boys with two scuba divers, and then they followed kind of a rope back, and they got back to safety. Everyone got back, no problems, and they're all safe. Well, I think what's interesting is that some of the boys did not know how to swim. And none of them knew how to scuba dive, of course. I find it fascinating that there are some people who don't know how to swim, because it's one of the things that all of us could do innately as an infant. And I've actually seen this. I've seen infants swim. We just automatically know how to do it. All mammals can swim. Elephants, squirrels, everything. But for some reason, as people, as we get older, we start fearing water and thinking like, oh, I can't do it. So what happens is that as we get older, we get things to help us swim. Like here's a little kid's swimmer thing. You know, you put it on them, and they put their arms through this. And so they can kind of get comfortable in the water. Some of you probably wore one of these when you were little. Some of you probably still are wearing one. But it's the whole idea of getting comfortable with it. And then eventually, hopefully, you learn how to swim where you don't need this anymore. Well, there are some adults who still want to hang on to something when they're near water because they're so terrified of water. They want a thing. But then there's a real joy when any of you learn how to swim. It's like, ah, something from inside. I can do this. I can float. I can dive under. This is phenomenal. I don't need something to help me. I can do it on my own. Well, in a sense, that's what Jesus is talking about in the gospel. He just called the apostles, and now he says, I want you to go out and make a difference. But he says, I don't want you to bring a lot of gimmicks with you. I don't want you to bring a lot of tricks, or I don't want you to bring a lot of things that you got to hang on to. Just you go out there. I mean, don't even bring any money. Don't bring any food. What? Can you imagine? I mean, I don't think Jesus was trying to create a show for Discovery Channel. It wasn't like that. No, nothing like that. But he was trying to get across to them. To say there's got to be something more than all these things we hang on to. I know for many of us here, we can't imagine life without our thing, like our phone, or our comb and mirror, or our air conditioning, or our vehicle, and on and on and on and on. But the problem comes is when we think that's the thing that's going to bring us happiness. So that's the thing that's going to fulfill us. As opposed to what Jesus says, oh, trust something deeper. Trust that God within you. So I've got a challenge for you. Sometime this week, actually I got two challenges. Sometime this week, I want you to try a set of time, like maybe an evening, where you don't have that thing you rely on so much. For many of you, I think it's your phones. Actually, try an evening without a phone, or maybe it's try an afternoon without TV, some of you who always have your TV on. Or get this, it could even be try a time with no air conditioning. Whatever you think it is that you have to have during these summer days, try without. Okay, that's one challenge. The second challenge, sometime this week, maybe tomorrow, I want you to think of what your life would be like if you totally trusted God. That if you knew that the words you're going to say your actions, you totally have God's support. That whatever encounter you had, that God would be there saying, right on, that's exactly what you need to do. Try a day where you imagine that everything you did or say was completely supported by God. Now, of course, I mean, don't go off and be a jerk, or don't go off and scream at people. Go off and be as you would, but instead of trying to live in fear or saying, how is this going to come across or what's going on, trust the God within you. The God that says, you can do this. You know the right things to say. You know the right actions. Go for it. Now, in that first reading, we've got Amos, who he says, I'm a shepherd. I don't know what I'm doing with this prophet stuff. But indeed, God says to him, you're going to be fine. I've got your back. You can do this. And I think for all of us, it's the same. Whether you've got to face that surgery, whether you've got to deal with that difficult person at work, whether you've got that big game coming, where you've got that problem with that family member, or you just got that kind of, that down feeling. Imagine what it would be like if God said to you, dive in. I got you. You're not going to drown. You can do this. You're going to be okay.